Hi everyone, it's Professor Primpton. In this video, we're going to talk about the break-even analysis project. So in this project, you're given a letter from LG Electronics, and they are manufacturing projectors. The company lost their chief production analyst, and they have a large amount of data, and they have no one to help them with their questions. So they're asking for your temporary services. So the data they are providing are the production cost and the wholesale price for a projector at each associated production level. So in the first column of the table, you have the production level, which is the number of projectors that they are actually producing, the wholesale price in dollars for each production level, and then the cost that it actually cost them to produce that number of projectors in dollars. And then the company has some pressing questions. They want to know what is the fixed cost and the variable cost for a projector produced by the company. They want to know approximately at what production level will they break even, specifically at what production level and what wholesale price. For a projector, will the cost and the revenue be equal? Will the company still make a profit at a production level of 200 projectors? And what are the marginal profit values at the break-even points? What do these values mean for the company's profits? So this is the letter that you're given and the data that's provided. So in this break-even analysis project, you have several questions that you need to be answered from the letter. Well, in this project, I've broken down each of the questions that need to be answered into problems that are then broken up by parts. So number one says, LG Electronics needs to determine the fixed cost and the variable cost per projector. We need to find an equation or a function that models the cost data provided in the table. Find the linear regression equation, C of X, for the cost data using the production level X as the independent variable. Round the coefficients in the linear regression equation to two decimal places. So part A. What is the linear regression equation C of X? So whether you've actually have done linear regression before or not, I'm going to show you the steps on how to calculate the linear regression equation. So since the production level is represented as X in this problem, and it's the independent variable, the first column in the data table is representing the X values, and the cost is representing the Y values, or the dependent variable. So to enter in data in the graphing calculator, you need to go to Stat, and then hit enter on edit. So you should have this blank screen. You should have L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. These are the list, and this is where you can store data in the graphing calculator. L1 will be for our independent variable or the X values. So the production level will go in this list, which was 117, 156, 187. Each time hit enter to get the next value, 215, then 233. Scroll over to L2. L2 will represent the Y values, or the dependent variable. In this case, it's the cost, because we want to calculate cost based on the production level of projectors. So L2 is not the wholesale price, it's the cost. So enter in 465,000, 488,000, 494,000, 508,000, and 515,000. Once you have the data stored in the graphing calculator, now you're ready to actually calculate regression. So go to Second, Quit, or the Mode button. You need to be back on the home screen to actually calculate regression. So now go back to Stat. You notice that there's a couple different menus at the top. You have Edit, Calc, and Test. Use the arrow key to scroll over to Calc, and you want option number 4, which is linear regression. And it tells us in the calculator what the answer will look like. Ax plus b. So we know that linear functions are x to the first power. The coefficient in front of x is the slope. In this case, they're calling a the slope, and b is the y-intercept, and b is the constant term. So hit enter on linear regression. Now let's make sure that this screen is correct. The independent variable was the list 1, or the production level. The y list, or the dependent variable, was the cost, which was in list 2. So yes, everything's correct. Scroll down to calculate, or just hit enter, and you're given the linear regression coefficients. The equation is y equals ax plus b. The a is the coefficient in front of the x, which is 414.85 if you round the two decimal places, and the b, the y-intercept or the constant term, is $418,663.57. So don't use y. The function that we want to find is c of x. So C of X is equal to 414.85X plus $418,663.57. So that's the answer to part A. We actually found the linear regression equation C of x using the graphing calculator. So now that we have the linear regression equation, we can talk about part B. What are the fixed cost and the variable cost per projector produced by the company? Explain what the fixed cost and the variable cost represent for the company, LG Electronics, and make sure that the coefficients A and B from the last part are around the two decimal places. So you can use the linear regression equation to find out what the fixed cost and the variable cost are. So that's what part B is asking you to do. And now number two, since the company needs to determine the break-even points for its cost and revenue, we need to find an equation that models the wholesale price data. So find a quadratic equation, P of X. So P of X is the price demand or the wholesale price data provided in the table of values, using the production level X again as the independent variable. Round the coefficients in the quadratic regression equation to two decimal places. Part A, what is the quadratic regression equation, lowercase p of x? So again, I'm going to show you how to find the quadratic regression equation using the graphing calculator. This time they're telling us that x is representing the production level as the independent variable, so that's the same as the linear regression equation we had earlier, but the output values, or the dependent variable this time, is for wholesale price. So let's go back to stat. Edit. We want to edit the data. Notice that L1 is perfectly fine because the production level was represented as X, and X was in list 1. But notice that list 2 is the same data that we had before for cost. We want to enter in L2 as the wholesale price. So scroll over using the arrow keys so that L2 is highlighted. Hit clear, and then hit enter. And it'll clear out the entire list for you. So now let's enter in the wholesale prices. You have $5,030, $4,149, $3,267, $2,333, and the last one is $1,664. Once you have the production levels under list 1 and the wholesale price under list 2, go back to second, quit, so you're on the home screen. Stat for regression. Scroll over to calculate again. But this time we don't want number 4 for linear regression, we want to calculate the quadratic regression equation. So that's number 5. So the quadratic regression, let's make sure everything on this screen is correct. The x's were the independent variable production level, that's in list 1. The y values are in list 2, that was the wholesale price this time. So yep, they are correct. Scroll down and calculate, or just hit enter, and they give you the quadratic regression equation. So the y is lowercase p of x, that's the output values, the wholesale price. It's a quadratic equation. It's ax squared plus bx plus c. So the coefficients that you are given from the quadratic regression are a is negative 0.08 if you round the two decimal places, the b is 0.16 if you round the two decimal places, and the coefficient c is 6,152.73 if you round the two decimal places. So the wholesale price would be P of x is equal to negative 0.08x squared plus 0.16x plus 6,152.73. So that answers part A. That gives you the quadratic regression equation, lowercase p of x. So now that we have the quadratic regression equation, we're going to talk about part B. Determine the revenue function R of x is equal to x times p of x. So if you remember from earlier in the semester, we defined revenue as price times quantity. So the price is the wholesale price, lowercase p of x. The x is standing for the quantity, the production level of the projectors. So revenue is x times p of x. Once you have the wholesale price from the previous part, now you have a way of finding the revenue function. Part C. Use a graphing calculator to find the break-even points, which they're telling us is the intersection points for the company. At what production levels, x, will the cost and the revenue functions be equal? Round your answers to the nearest projector produced and sold. So finding the intersection points may have been a topic that you may have seen in a previous algebra course. If you want to graph the functions, we want to graph the cost and the revenue functions and find their intersection points. Go to y equals. The y1 will be our cost function. Well, we found that out in the first problem. It was 414.85 times x plus 418,663.57. Now y2 will be what you come up with in part B for the revenue function. It's the wholesale price times x. So take the quadratic regression equation for p of x and multiply everything by x. And when you do that, you'll have negative 0.08x cubed plus 0.16x squared plus 6,152.73 times x. That's what you'll come up with for the revenue function. Now, if you hit graph, you may not actually see the functions graphed. You need to set up your viewing window. To go to window, that's next. You need to set up your window to be as follows. The minimum x value, you're talking about production level of projectors. The least you can produce is 0 projectors. The maximum level was in the table. The table went up to 233 projectors. Let's go up to 250 projectors. The x scale, how much do you want the tick marks on the x-axis to count by? Well, since we're going between 0 and 250, I want to count by 50. The y values were representing dollars, the wholesale price in dollars or the cost in dollars. The least is $0, and the maximum cost that we had in the table was $515,000. So let's go up to $550,000. Now the y scale is how much do you want the y tick marks to count by on the vertical axis? Let's count by $100,000 because I'm going between 0 and $550,000. Now hit graph. So the first function that was graphed was the cost function. We got that from linear regression. The second function that was graphed is the revenue function, and we got that from part B. The revenue was x times the wholesale price. We are interested in finding the intersection points. So go to second, calc, which is the trace button. We want intersect. So hit enter on intersect. Now it's asking you a couple questions. What is your first curve? The first curve that was graphed was the cost function, which is correct, y1. So hit enter. What is your second curve? The second curve should have been the revenue function, which is y2. That's correct. So hit enter. Now it wants us to guess. What value do we want to guess for the intersection points? Well, it matters which one we want to guess because there are two different intersection points. Scroll to the left using the arrow keys, and you'll have this little cursor that comes up. I want to guess right there where the intersection point occurs, hit enter, and it tells us the intersection point occurs when the production level is 79.90 projectors. Well, it says round to the nearest projector in the problem, so this would be 80 projectors. If 80 projectors are produced, then the company will break even because the cost and the revenue are the same. So I'll leave you to find the other production level where the cost and the revenue functions are equal by finding the other intersection points. Part D, what should the wholesale prices, lowercase p of x, for a projector if the company needs to break even? Round your answers to the nearest dollar. So in other words, what this problem is asking is that now that we know where the cost and the revenue functions are going to break even, we know those values of x where cost and revenue are the same, now we can find out what the price is if we can plug in those x values. So this problem is asking you to find what should the price be for the projectors when the company needs to break even. And then number three, LG Electronics needs to determine the optimal level of production that is best for the company. We will use the regression equation for the cost and the revenue to construct a function that models the company's profit. Part A, find the profit function, capital P of X, which we defined earlier in the course as profit is revenue subtract cost. So the revenue function we've talked about earlier, the cost function was from linear regression. So you subtract the two functions to find out what the profit function is. So part B, does the company make a profit at a production level of 200 projectors? So from the previous part, you found out the profit function. Now you want to find out what is the profit function when there's 200 projectors produced. Part C, find the marginal profit function P prime of X. So we talked about previously in the course that the marginal profit function is the derivative of the profit function. So find the derivative of the profit function. And then the last part, part D, says determine the marginal profit at the production levels X, where the company will break even, and interpret the results for the company. In particular, is the company's profit increasing or decreasing at each break-even point? So once you have the marginal profit function, part D is asking you, use the break-even points that you found previously and this marginal profit function to find out what is the change in the profit at those production levels X. And interpret your results for the company. And in particular, is the company's profit increasing or decreasing based on your answers for the marginal profit at those break-even points? So this finishes our discussion on the break-even analysis project. If you have any questions about how to calculate linear regression or quadratic regression or find intersection points on a graphing calculator, please let me know. Or if you have any other questions while you work on the project, please let me know that as well.